3, 2, 1. Command has been given. Crank them up.
Let's go.
When I say I don't know, I don't know.
Let's go, baby.
Now, the morning drive.
Buckle up, everybody.
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
It's a game changer.
I listen to you guys every single day on my way to work.
Well, again, I'm not a doctor, nor do I play one on the radio.
You guys are amazing.
What are you doing over there?
I'm going to the top.
The morning drive with Mike Bagley and Pete Pistone.
To the bat balls.
SiriusXM, NASCAR Radio Channel 90, live and on the air for this Tuesday morning, April 4th, 2023. Mike Bagley here in Delmarva Studio 1D. We've got Pistol Pete Pistone in the Paisan Palace in Chicago. We've got Sammy and Davey in Studio 134 of the Beltway Bureau at our nation's capital. We welcome each and every one of you to this TMDJ Tuesday. My playlist brings us to green. Lil Nas X getting us started here on this Tuesday morning. Top of the morning to you, Triple P.
Good morning, Bagman. Good morning, everybody. Happy TMDJ Tuesday to one and all as the week rolls on here on another stormy day in the city of Chicago. More severe storms tonight. Batten down the hatches, so boys, get ready. They're coming your way, like last week. Eesh.
We had some severe weather over the weekend. I don't know if it's made the news where you all are. It's made Philadelphia news here. Sussex County, Bridgeville, Ellendale, down in those reaches. That's just south of Milford by a little bit. Milford and Harrington, or Harrington, as some folks say, but the locals call it Harrington. We had an F3. Was 14 miles. It traveled 14 miles, and it was like 70 yards wide, something like that. It's the biggest tornado that's hit here in like 40 years. We don't get tornadoes here, really. We just get hurricanes whenever they make them their way here. But so this was something that caught a lot of folks off guard. Had them in Jersey. There were a total of 6 or 7 that touched down on Saturday. I was getting the alerts when I was in Richmond. I'm like, what in the world is going on up home? So I tapped into our Ring doorbell. And we had a power outage at some point because when I tapped into the doorbell, the lights were all at night. I mean, the whole neighborhood was dark. So we were dead in the water there for a little bit.
On the way home from Richmond on Saturday, we got off 395. We were getting blown all over 390, all over 95 on the way back up because of the wind and stuff. We took the easy pass when we got up there, passed everybody and said sayonara. Got off the easy pass, went to get off the highway.
Bye-bye now.
We get off the highway on 395 at the exit we get off at normally, get to a spot, and the wind is going, and like trees are going crazy, limbs are falling off, and Tori goes, well, I'm surprised that this spot has power at it still. At the stoplight, power went out. Like, I'm...
Shut your mouth.
5 seconds after she made the comment, the power went out. But then, of course... Nobody knows that when the lights go out at a stoplight, it becomes a four-way stop.
That's correct. Oh, they don't know. They can't do it, right?
It should, but it doesn't.
Yeah,
it
right.
became a free... I'm talking Mad Max-style Thunderdome. Where's Tina Turner? Like, I'm serious. I mean, it was...
It's amazing.
You're trying to just, all right, these two cars went, so then these two cars go... No, everyone was just going. And then I felt terrible. There was an older gentleman who had a... wheelie walker thing that was trying to cross the street at the same time, and so it's 50 mile an hour wind gust. This guy's getting almost blown over and almost hit by cars because no one can see him in the middle of the road and stuff. Just take your time, people. Everything will be okay.
Mm-hmm. So I guess around here on Friday they spotted 100 tornadoes around the area. I think 10 of them touched down. And so hopefully we don't get it so bad tonight. I feel like what happened to the days where you just get a good old-fashioned thunderstorm? Because I like thunderstorms. I like sitting and watching them roll in.
I love them.
But it love feels them. Like it, we don't get those anymore, that it's always severe and hail and wind. And the thing that worries me the most, we've been in here now since 2000, in this house since 2004. So the trees in the back are almost 20 years older, and I just worry about tree damage more than anything. But anyway, hopefully it won't be as... severe as it was there, but if it is, take precaution, everybody. Batten down the hatches. Congratulations, UConn, finishing up March Madness with their win last night. Feel sorry for everybody on the East Coast with a 9:20 p.m. Eastern Time tip-off I'm being told one shiny moment didn't go off the air till 12:10 Eastern time last night, Sammy.
Did you watch it, Baggy?
Baggy.
Stop, please. Come on. That's laughable.
No, no. You know, it was San Diego State was sort of the Cinderella team. Sadly, it really wasn't much of a game. I mean, I think UConn was up by 12 at half, and they kind of pulled away. But I think overall, I thought it was a good tournament. But congratulations, UConn. And they are already the 12-1 favorite to win next year's championship. I don't know how you project next year's championship when they haven't even cut the nets down from this year's championship, especially in college basketball where people just come and go these days, you know, with the transfer portal. But anyway, basketball is done.
I'm sure that they're already doing their mock drafts.
Not yet. not yet in college. But so that's in the rearview mirror. And then real quick, another thing I saw yesterday, I had to laugh. So a lot of teams in baseball are having their home openers. You know, they opened if they opened on the road last Thursday, then a lot of teams are having their home opener. Well, the Brewers had their home opener yesterday afternoon against the Mets.
Yes.
Did you hear about this? So, you know, here in NASCAR, we have flyovers during the national anthem pretty much every week. Well, the Brewers decided we're going to do a flyover before the first pitch of the Mets and the Brewers. But the roof of the ballpark where the Brewers play was closed, so nobody saw the flyover.
No.
What are you thinking, folks?
Hey, was it raining or anything, or was it? Or did
it was cold. It was like, you know, 40. So listen, I've been to that park a million times. A nice park. Close the roof. What are you doing a flyover for then?
Imagine like the game day planner guy. All right, Jets are coming. Oh my God, the roof is closed.
You know what that sounds like? That sounds like that the flyover was scheduled way in advance, and probably in the meeting was like, now, but what if it's cold and the roof's closed? Oh yeah, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Well, guess what? The roof was closed and the bridge was closed too. And hey, you know what? We've already got it scheduled. We've already paid for it. Let them fly.
So a couple of fans were interviewed and they said, what'd you think of the flyover? And the guy goes, well, we heard it.
Man, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, it's a shame.
You know, one of the coolest flyovers I have ever seen, I was on my, there's a couple. One of them happened at Atlanta and one of them happened at Kansas. The one at Kansas, I'm on this before I started doing the pre-race show. So I'm standing on the back of the billboard waiting to go, and we do the anthem, and then, you know, I'm like, well, where's the flyover? So standing there with your hand on your heart, and you just want to know where it's coming from. Mm-hmm. So I'm kind of looking around, and I'm looking over one and two. Nah, not coming from there, no backstretch, no front stretch. And I happened to turn around, and it was, I guess, a B-2 stealth bomber. I want to tell you something. First of all, it's a stealth bomber. You don't know that it's coming.
Except you do, because it's loud as hell probably. Ain't nothing stealth about that.
No, it's not.
No?
It's not.
It's
no.
Stealth. It's stealth.
Even when it's over top of you.
Really?
There's just not that much noise that I recall. Yeah. Or maybe he laid off the gas. I don't know what, but
I should have shut off the engine, turned off the switches.
Well, gas prices the way they are. I don't blame him.
Shape. By the way, speaking of turning off switches, I'm glad Bubba Wallace turned off his lights at the end of the first stage Sunday. He looked like a railroad crossing. He came by me, and I see four lights are flashing red, and it's like, Bubba, turn off the lights. And then he did after the stage was over. Anyway, so I turn around, and here comes this almost on top. It scared me to death. It's very intimidating. The look of it is very intimidating. It obviously can drop a hearty payload when it needs to. And then the other one was at Atlanta. They had those Apache helicopters. They had four of them in formation. And this is back when MRN did the races back then. And I looked over my shoulder and, they just rose up and they were hovering.
That's cool.
Over, like, my turn position. I'm like, hey.
Easy.
Sam, I forgot to tell you this. So when I left the office the other day, speaking of things hovering low, I was going across 395. I was going across the bridge, the Potomac. And about that time, here comes a helicopter flying. Military helicopter. He was so low, and I'm not exaggerating, I could almost see the whites of the pilot's eyes. He was almost on the I thought he was going to hit the top of the car. That's how low they were going. Did they do that a lot?
Yeah, he's probably going to the Pentagon.
Sure.
Well, can you get up in the air a little bit? God.
You're talking about... It's kind of... This is pretty badass what they do at Arlington for when if someone high up in the Air Force dies and has like an Air Force or a Navy... I think they might do it for Navy pilots too. I don't know, but I know it's for Air Force pilots. They will send and do flyovers with like F-16s or F-18s or whatever of the the funeral service for someone in the Air Force and stuff like that. So it'll be like 2 o'clock on a Tuesday, and you'll just be, I'll be like out on my walk, and all of a sudden you'll hear, and it's, you look up or you'll look out the window, and it's, you know, two fighter jets flying by doing those things for like a funeral and stuff like that. That's, I mean, it's not like a stealth bomber flying by, but it's also just, I don't know, it's kind of cool that they do that for those people who've served. And it's just kind of cool they do it on like a random afternoon where you just don't expect it. And then all of a sudden, sometimes you think you're under attack. Other times it's just, oh, someone important probably passed away.
Well, speaking of somebody important, flyovers and all that stuff, I always know when the president is coming home, because the president lives about 20 minutes from me, 25 minutes north of me.
He's in the White House.
And he, well, no, the Delaware home, not the temporary home, the full residence.
Yeah.
But when he comes home, he lands over here at the Newcastle County Airport. Sometimes they'll take Marine One, sometimes Air Force One comes flying in. And then they literally shut 95 down. That's called locally Joe Jam. We've got a Joe Jam Friday at 5:30. That means the president's coming in.
Why don't you go out there and bring him a steak sandwich or something?
Hang on, what kind of security do they have at though? What airport is that again?
The Newcastle County Airport?
Yeah, like
it turns into a fortress. That's an Air National Guard. And he doubles
protected.
As a
he's fine.
Alero flight.
I thought he would just. I thought he would just fly into, where's the place in Delaware? The Air Force base that they fly into and stuff like that.
That's behind Dover. That's Dover.
That's way far. 45 minutes south of
him. Oh, okay. I've been to that
Air Force
airport
base.
To him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Either that or Philly International, and that, though, really asking for it there.
But Kent County's safer.
We always get that heads up, and when before he
heads
comes,
up.
I have jet fighters flying over the house and military helicopters. You can tell that they are cleansing the airspace before Air Force One comes in.
Cleansing the airspace.
Yes.
I like that.
And
that's
as we
nice.
Prepare for a Joe Jam, not a toe jam, but a Joe Jam.
Okay.
Because they shut 95 down and his motorcade then goes out to his house in West Wilmington.
I just use Febreze to clear my airspace.
Well, if the president ever comes your way, get some extra supplies of that. My two favorite flyovers, always the Thunderbirds at Daytona, for sure. And then we have the Air and Water Show here in Chicago in August, and it goes up and down the lakefront. So to your guys' point, it happens usually on a Saturday or Sunday. They practice like on a Thursday, Friday, and they just literally come all the way down Lakeshore and then go up to like the Evanston. They turn around, they come back. Well, one day I was at Wrigley. It was an afternoon game on a Thursday, and they were practicing. And I think it was the Reds, Tom Browning. Remember him, pitcher? He had no idea what was happening. He was on the mound, and this jet comes roaring by the lakefront. He like jumped off the mound, threw his hat down. He thought we were under attack at Wrigley Field on a Thursday afternoon.
That's
it
practice.
Scared the bejesus out of him.
Speaking of practice, one of the cool things, it used to be going into the All-Star race or Memorial Day weekend.
Yeah.
But the Blue Angels put on a show over in Annapolis. I think it's around Navy graduation, around that time. But like the Tuesday or Wednesday, Thursday before the Blue Angels practice. So I would go to Annapolis, and like the state house is in the middle of Annapolis. Well, the employees would go out on the spire. I guess it's called the spire or the steeple, whatever that is. There's a little observation deck. You look up and like, all the people from the offices are standing outside on their patios or balconies, whatever. The streets are filled with people just standing there, just watching the Blue Angels just zig and zag. You basically get a free show.
Yeah.
It's pretty awesome and loud. Yeah.
Oh, it's
it
loud.
Rattles the windows.
That's how the air show is in Chicago. And I used to live at 500 Lakeshore Drive. That's all the way right at the end. You go to the deck, observation deck. We had like a bird's eye view. It was fun. It's great.
Would you guys go up and do, if you could, would you go up with those Thunderbirds and I don't know if you go up with the Blue Angels, but I know you go up with the Thunderbirds, don't you?
Like, you know the answer that I have for you, Baggy. Would you ever do that? Obviously, I would not.
I don't think I'm capable of doing that. I mean, I would love to know. I know people that have gone up with them.
Me too.
But there are two things I do not want to have happen. I don't want to black out, which you will. And
you
number
will.
Two, I don't want to lose my lunch. And
which
I know that
will.
I will.
They tell you to. People I know that have done it, they like, yeah, just do it. Just don't fight it. Go for it.
Well, you can't do it with a helmet on. It's like you need your finger to get in there and make it happen. It's like,
well, okay, well, take it easy.
Like, just saying, it's like,
I can
try to enjoy my.
I don't need a finger.
No, they meaning like you. and enjoying your post-toasties out there this morning, everybody. No, like, not force yourself, but if it feels like it's going to happen, aren't there? I thought some people told me their bags, they've got it covered up there.
Yeah. I would just feel bad that someone has to would have to clean that up after me.
How about that?
I think they're used to it by now, though.
I would. That's I would part of the love. Process. I'm afraid of heights. Like I am. Like I said yesterday, climbing up that. You know, on Saturday, climbing up that ladder. Like maybe.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
climbing
yeah.
up that hill. Oh, and you are up that.
Like, yeah, but that's I would funny. Do. I would do that in a heartbeat. I would.
You would? Oh, you would.
Yeah, I would get in the. I mean, because that's like it's unattached heights that scare me. So if I'm locked into a, if I'm locked in, I'm good. And then mm-hmm. if they gotta eject me, they eject me. There's a parachute attached to that thing. I'll be fine.
Incoming. So here comes Sammy. Okay.
Sammy missile. Pew.
All right. It's not the movement of that first turn position at Richmond. It's being up there with that happen. Now it all makes sense.
Oh, I didn't know
you
that
were going you... at a reduced pace going up, and yeah. I'm like, okay, yo, rung by rung. Well, no, he took his time. I mean, I'm not giving him a hard time because, listen, I've been there, and I used to be scared of heights, too.
I don't like it. So those kind of ladders, this is really random, those ladders make me think of Home Alone 2 when Macaulay Culkin puts this gel on a fire escape ladder in that Daniel Stern goes to jump on, and he grabs onto it, and his hands slip off, and he just falls and hits his back. I have a irrational fear of climbing down a ladder and that happening, like missing a rung, slipping, and, you know.
Down you go.
Just going down, man.
Well, some of the ladders that Baggy climbs up on, some of those billboards that I've been with him on, those are tight.
It's scary,
man. I agree. Those are tight. Then you got to get up and you got to do the little shimmy around, you know, and get into your little platform there where he camps out for 4 hours.
He even said, he goes, you could bring a couple barley pops up to the turn if you want to while you're, for yourself, not for the bag, man, for myself maybe if I wanted to, if I didn't need to, but I wasn't gonna bring those up with me and fall off that balcony.
I would have two shots before I go up, just, you know, settle the nerves.
I was working. I didn't have any beforehand. I was going to be nice and safe. We don't want to have an issue with anything falling off there, and Baggy's got to file a worker's comp claim.
It's still better than the other
one. With Sammy being very delicate of the heights, we didn't know if we needed any grandpappy's cost hurt or not.
That's what I'm saying. Like, because I was nervous to climb up there, and I was like, nah, we're not doing that.
Grandpappy's cuffs. Here you go, son. This will settle you down. Have some of this.
They'll calm that stomach. Coming up, bottom of the hour, headline check number one. Coming up at 8 a.m. Eastern, we'll visit with Elton Sawyer, NASCAR Senior VP of Competition. Also this morning, the calendar around 8:50, 9 o'clock this morning, another installment of Behind the Wheel with Joey Logano. He'll be with us and taking your telephone calls between 9 and 10 Eastern. We're also going to do a little deeper dive into the Toyota Owners 400 Race Weekend Tuesday takeaways with you at 866 Pit Lane, and also on Twitter at SiriusXM NASCAR, hashtag TMD NASCAR. TMD is brought to you in part by our friends from the NASCAR Hall of Fame. The NASCAR Hall of Fame is the home of legends where you can explore the past, present, and future of the sport we all love. Plan your next visit at NASCARHall.com.